This is a beginner Blender Python tutorial where we'll be taking a look at Python dictionaries, and we'll take a look at some examples of how you can use these dictionaries in your scripts. Hey, I'm Victor Stepanov. I'll be guiding you through this beginner Blender Python tutorial. Today we're going to be taking a look at Python dictionaries. We're going to be learning about what Python dictionaries are, why you want to use them, how you would use them, and then some examples of Blender Python scripts. So what are Python dictionaries? Well, they're actually not far off of the dictionaries that we would use to look up the meaning of words. So you have a word and then you look up the definition of that word. Well, Python has a similar idea of dictionaries where you have a key and a value, right? You have a key to access that value quickly. Imagine if you had a dictionary, but it wasn't organized in any way. So it wasn't alphabetically ordered, and you'd have to go through every single word in that dictionary to find the word that you're looking for. Well, this basically helps Python to quickly find values that you really want without going through a list, for example. So if we take a look at Blender, we have the add-ons window where you search for add-ons. You can kind of think of that as being a dictionary where you use the name of the add-on to quickly find the settings for that particular add-on. Also, there's the outliner where you can quickly find objects just using the name. So similar idea here. So how would you use these dictionaries? We're going to take a look at how you create a dictionary, how you add items to it, and how do you access items in a dictionary. So first things first, you have a special method called dict, and then you use that and create a dictionary just like so. There's also a shorthand version to this where you use these curly braces. You can also fill out a dictionary with some key and value pairs right away. So you have this right here where you have the color and then the representation in hex code. Then you can have different types in the values. So in this case, we have a number, we have a tuple, and then a string right here. So you can use different types there, but the key type, the thing that's on the left, has to be the same type. For example, if you're using strings to name each key, you should use that all the time. Here's another example of using lists as the values. Let's head on over to Blender to start coding this in the interactive Python console. I'm in the scripting workspace of Blender. You can scroll to the right and hit scripting right here. I expanded the interactive Python console right here and zoomed in so you can see the text better. Here I'm defining the colors that I want to have in my dictionary. Again, it's pretty straightforward. I'm already adding some key value pairs right here. And now when I type my colors, I can get that dictionary printed out for me. What if you want to add values after you create a dictionary? Well, you can use this syntax right here where you use the square brackets and assign the new key, and then on the right, you'll be assigning the value of that key. To retrieve values from a dictionary, you'll be using the similar square brackets just as you are assigning values. Now you're retrieving them using this syntax. So you would just use this, for example, to get the pastel red, and then so on down the line. Let's take a look in Blender how this looks in the interactive Python console. And the cool thing about Blender is that in the interactive Python console, you can hit tab to start auto-completing what is in a dictionary. And you can get the values like so. But what happens if I try to access a value that is not in the dictionary? For example, I'm just going to try to access brick. Well, that's going to give us an issue because that key doesn't exist in the dictionary. So it's a key error right here. And to safeguard yourself from accessing a key that doesn't exist in the dictionary, Python has a really nice function called get. As you can see, I tried to get the value that's behind the key brick, and it doesn't really give me anything. Actually, if you print out the value that it gets returned, it's actually none. And we can use this to our advantage and check if the value is none or not using an if statement. For example, like so. As you can see, I'm testing if this result is none, so it's not. If this result is not none, then we print out the value right here. And since this didn't get executed, as you can see, nothing happened after I ran this code. This means that this body was not executed because this is false. Now, if we do the same thing with the brick red, you can see that this will actually work because this right here resolves to true. Also, you can loop through items of a dictionary using this following syntax, where you'll access the key and the value on each iteration of the for loop. All right, now it's time to look at some examples. All right, let's take a look at the first example. You'll find this code in the description under example number one. At the top, we're importing some Python modules, BPY for allowing Python to access Blender's functionality, and random to access some functionality that'll help us generate random numbers and select things randomly. Next, we have a definition of a function right here. It's not super complicated. We're just adding a plane into the scene, setting the location that we pass in as the argument, creating a material, and assigning the diffuse color that we pass in as the argument. And then finally, we just add the material that we just created here into the material list of this current active object. So we're using this function right here, and right here. All right, so let's take a look at the example. We have our dictionary with colors. Note that I have already converted the hex color codes into an RGBA value right here for all these colors. The first thing, first usage is pretty straightforward. I'm creating a new variable, accessing this color, and then passing it in, right? And then just setting the location. Next, I'm actually just skipping this variable right here. You don't have to create it. I'm just trying to show you an example of just using this dictionary right away, like so. And then finally, this is a more interesting example where we create a list out of all the keys from a dictionary. So you can collect all these keys right here and create a list out of them. And then we're randomly selecting a key, right? So we have a random key at this point. And then we're using this key right here to get that color, and then using this function one more time. So let's remove everything from the scene by hitting AX and then delete. And then let's run the script. And you can see that we have these colors applied to these planes. And let's actually click material preview. And then let's run the script one more time. I'm gonna delete everything and run it again. And you can see that we have a random color assigned to the last plane. All right, for your second example, we're gonna need some helper code to start us off. We're gonna create a scene. And you'll find this code in particular under example two start. And this is just gonna add some icospheres, some cubes and cones into the scene at random locations. You can see that we're generating random locations here. I'm just gonna delete everything from the scene and then run the script. And you can see that we have a number of these icospheres, cones and cubes in the scene. All right, let's look at the main example. All right, example number two is gonna have this following code. We're defining a dictionary of lists. Note that I'm using variables for the keys. I'm using this on purpose so I can make sure that I am consistent with my keys. So if I make a typo that then I'm gonna make a typo in every single one of the usages of this key. So So I could have done this like so, but I'm making sure that I'm consistent by using these variables. You'll see in just a minute. So right here, we're creating a dictionary, and the values is going to be just a list for cubes, icospheres, and cones. We're going to be gathering all the cubes, icospheres, and cones into their own lists, right? So we're using the name of the current objects. We're looping over all the objects in the scene and testing for the name. So if the name of the object has cube in it, then we're going to add it using the cube key and then add that object to that list. Similar thing goes for icospheres and then cones. And then we're defining another dictionary. So we're going to use this dictionary to look up at what position we want these particular meshes to be. We're setting the Z coordinate, right? The Z axis. And cubes are going to be at 0, icospheres -5, and cones at 5. And we're just looping over that dictionary of the objects that we created right here. Right, and then we are looping over each one of those objects in that list, right? And then we're setting the Z value for the location property. And notice that I'm not searching for this value in any way. I'm just literally looking up using the key. So remember, the key right here is going to be the same thing for like icospheres and icospheres right here. So it's going to match up really nicely without doing any searching through any list or anything like that. So let's see how this works. I'm going to run this code and look at that. All the cubes are at Z equals to 0, and then the icospheres and the cones are up top. And if you're learning something new today or just enjoying this tutorial, make sure to give this video a like. I'll greatly appreciate it. All right, and for your final example, we're going to be using one of the Blender templates. Blender comes with some Python templates. So if you open templates, Python, and add on, add object, if you click that, it's going to open up some code right away. You should have something like this. And we're not going to even scroll down anywhere, because here you can see a really nice usage of the dictionary. So this is a dictionary that defines what this add-on is, in the sense of it gives it the name, the author, what Blender version this supports, locations where you can find this particular add-on, and so on and so forth. This is a great example of how you can use a dictionary, in particular providing some information. So I'm not going to be going over in depth what this add-on does in particular, like how it does it. I'll create a separate video just for this purpose, just keeping this video short. Let's clear the scene, and I want you to take a look at this add menu and mesh, and then under monkey, after we run this add-on script, we're going to add one more option. So let's do that. And actually, we can look and add square brackets and then 1, 2, 3. So you can see that this is not just some random add object getting added. We just modified it right here. Let's run the script. So it gets registered using this particular set of functions. Again, not going into detail here, but just know that this is a good example of using a dictionary in Blender. Let's run that, and let's open the menu, mesh, and then look at that, exactly what we updated just below right there. All right, let's summarize what we learned today. We learned what are Python dictionaries, why you would want to use them. We learned how to create a dictionary. We learned how to add items into a dictionary and then access them. And then we looked at some examples. I hope you enjoyed this video, and for more videos like this, make sure to subscribe, and thank you so much for watching.